Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's blessing, mercy, and love be upon all of us. Ameen. Dearest brothers and sisters, welcome to Islam for All. When we talk about Islam for all, it's important for us to understand that Allah, our Creator, He is the Creator of all things, from human to jinn, to angels, to the sky, the earth, moon, sun, stars, and everything in the universe. There is Allah, the Creator of all things. And also, He, Allah, is the sender of all prophets, from Adam to Noah, from Noah to Abraham, from Abraham to Ishmael, Isaac, and Moses, Jesus, and the last messenger of Allah for all mankind is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and may Allah's blessing be upon all of them. And also, He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the last messenger for all mankind. And in the Quran, if you look back into the Quran, you will see that Allah started the wahyu in Makkah by calling all mankind, Ayyuhannas, Ayyuhannas. Allah is addressing to all mankind, not only to a particular nation or tribes. Even Allah revealed His last book in Arabic, and the last messenger of Allah also is an Arab. But the difference between this prophet and the other prophets is this prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all mankind and also to the universe. Allah confirmed this. Number one, Allah is telling us so that we do not misunderstand who is our God, Allah. Allah said He is Rabbul Alamin. And that's why all Muslims, when they want to start their prayer, they are always being commanded by our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to start with Surah Al-Fatiha. And Surah Al-Fatiha, the first verse of Surah Al-Fatiha is Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, meaning all praise is for Allah. Alhamdu, all praises. All praises for who? Lillah, is only for Allah. Who is Allah? Rabb. He is not just a creator, but He also is the provider, the sustainer. The creator of what? The sustainer of what? Rabbul Alamin, Al-Alamin. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alamin. Allah is the God that we should praise because all praises belong to Him, and He is Rabbul Alamin, the God of the universe. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam by saying, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. Allah remind His last messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to inform fellow mankind, say to all mankind, say to the people, O Muhammad, that you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last messenger of Allah, was sent to all of them. That means Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not a prophet only for the Arabs. He is also the prophet for the Arabs, for the non-Arabs, for the white, for the black, for Muslim, for people who are not yet Muslim, and he is the prophet for the Indian, for the Chinese, for the European, and the Ajam. So we know now Allah, our God, do not belong to us only. He is the God of every one of us. So as Muslim, number one, we must believe that Allah is the only creator. That's all. We don't believe in any other gods except Allah Hu Ahad, Allah the only one. Even a lot of people who are not yet Muslim, they may have their own belief. They believe in their God, maybe a God that created the Hindus, there's a God who created the Chinese, there's a God for the European, for the white, there's a God for the black. They can claim anything, it's up to them. But we know the truth, and it's our duty to convey the truth to them. And that's why we are here, not to judge anybody. We are here to share the knowledge that Allah has given us. If we have received the hidayah from Allah, al-Islam, then we should bring Islam to all mankind. We should not keep it to ourselves. By keeping Islam to ourselves, we have betrayed Islam. We have failed ourselves being the follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because number one, Allah said, "Inna din 'inda Allah al-Islam," religion of Islam belong to Allah. Number one. That's why you said Islam for all. And when we say that Islam belongs to Allah, and Allah is the creator of everyone and everything, then nobody can say that Islam only for a particular race. Nobody can claim that Islam only my religion. No, but it's our religion. It's a religion for all of us. You know, for the Arab, for the non-Arab, for the Chinese, for the Indian, for the Malays, for the Pakistani, for anybody, any races in this world, Islam belongs to them. For the young, for the old, you know, for male and female. Maybe there are people who came, maybe Islam is only practical for the old, not for the young one. No. Islam is for the old, for the young, or for the young, for the old, and also for the rich and the poor, for every one of us. Because Islam is a way of life. Islam has taught that from the day you were born, how do you welcome the new child, the new offspring, until you die. From the day you were born, Islam has taught us what, how to handle a newborn child, until when you die, what should we do? How should we carry out the funeral, and so on. So now, number one, we Muslims must understand this first. Because if we don't understand that Islam is for all, then we may have a problem. And that's why we keep Islam just among ourselves. We thought that this religion belonged to us. We can do business with other people. We can have food with them, we have drink with them, we travel with them, we talk to them, we do business. We can do almost everything with everyone, except most of us as Muslims have failed to bring Islam to our not yet Muslim friends, brothers and sisters. Why? It's because we, maybe, I'm not saying that everybody have the same kind of feeling, but maybe some of us was taught that Islam belonged to us. Islam only for Muslim, but not for other people. That is where we went wrong. That's why it's important for us in this program, Islam for All, to understand. Number one, it is our duty as Muslim first to understand our deen that we call Islam. Because if we fail to understand Islam in the way Allah wants us to understand, in the way Islam wants us to understand, of course, then we may have a problem. And the spreading of Islam is stopped by us because we thought that Islam belonged to us. But now we understand that Islam is for all. Now, when we understand Islam for all, the basic thing that all Muslims must understand is the foundation of this religion. Everything that is a foundation, asas, and the foundation of this religion is given into three categories. It is divided into three big categories. Number one, we said al-aqidah or arkanu iman. Number one, we as Muslims must know the six articles of faith, why we call arkanu iman. Inshallah, after the break, we'll come back.
Spread the word of Islam. Spread the word of Islam.
Alhamdulillah. Brothers and sisters, Now, we did mention early that the foundation, the first foundation, is the foundation of Iman, faith. Of course, we must believe in something. And there is no religion that didn't start with belief. When you say religion, that means there is a belief. Now, as Muslim, Allah and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have come up with 6 articles of faith that you must believe. The minimum is 6. Number one, you believe that Allah exists. Now, you cannot be a Muslim if you don't believe in Allah. But the strange thing that happened today, there are people who claim that I'm a Christian, I'm a Buddhist, but I believe in Allah. So what is the difference between we believe in Allah and they believe in Allah? Nowadays, you come across friends, your good friend maybe, your good neighbors. They say, I have no problem in believing Allah. I believe my God is Allah. But I'm a Christian. But I'm a Hindu. I'm a free thinker. I'm a socialist. But they say, I believe in Allah. Do we believe in that? Do we accept that kind of belief? We should accept that. Why we accept that? It's not that because we accept this because through our own judgment, through our own value, because Allah confirmed in the Quran, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَ اللَّهِ. Allah said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you ask the pagans, those idol worshippers, those worship stone, wood, human things that they made by themselves. This is called the man-made God. A human made something, and later on that something is been worshipped by them. The pagan, they worship many gods. And all of us know the history of before Islam. In the Kaaba, the holy Kaaba, they are surrounded by 360 idols, big and small, thin and tall. You see, this is what happened. Then everybody is worshipping their own gods, and they put their god inside and around Kaaba. Now, when Prophet Muhammad asked them, who created the heaven, the sky, and the earth? They said, Allah. They all said, Allah. Why they said Allah? Because they know there's only one God. No one denied one God. Nobody can deny that there is God. Even Shaitan, who Allah cursed, Shaitan, who has been misleading all of us, he also accept and acknowledge there's one God, Allah. Now, if Shaitan acknowledge there's one God, who are we not to accept that there's only one God? But what is the main difference between they and us? They claim they also believe in Allah. We claim we believe in Allah. There's no difference. And that's why we said there is no difference in Tawheed ar-Rububiyyah. There is no difference among mankind in believing in one God. All believe in one God. But the main difference is Tawheed Uluhiyyah. We do not just claim that we believe in one God. We do not only say, I believe in one God and my God is Allah. Where the Shaitan also said Allah. King Pharaoh also said Allah. Everybody say Allah. But we worship Him alone. We do not just claim or say Allah is one, but we worship the only one God, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bow to Him, we prostrate to Him, we ask help from Him, we put our trust in Him. Everything we do, we go back to Him. Meaning, we do not associate Allah in the act of worship. Any form of worship, we worship Him alone. And that's the big difference. That's why if you go to the mosque, or you look at the Muslim and they perform their prayer, there's no idols in front of them. There's no images in front of them. There's no tree. I mean, they won't worship trees, stars, moon, sun, human, or any holy man. No, even the prophet that they love so much, from Adam to Noah to Abraham to Moses to Jesus to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they love all of them. Because Allah said, لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُلِي. You are not supposed to differentiate, to accept some prophet and deny other prophet. You cannot do that as Muslim. As a Muslim, you must accept all the prophets, like how you accept Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because all of them are sent by the same God, Allah. That's why we must have the right understanding first. If we don't have the right understanding, then we may have problem. Now, when we know that, and we worship that one God that we claim, where the other people who say that, I am a communist, I am a socialist, I am a free thinker, but at the same time, I have no problem in believing in one God, that is Allah. They can claim, they can say, and we can accept that. We agreed upon that. But now we are very different, because when they worship something that they claim there is one God, they started. Now they started to have something in between as a medium. They're starting to have an image, they draw a picture, maybe, or they start to have an idols. That is the main difference between we and them. That's why in the mosque, how big the mosque is, you can see there is no statue, no image, no idols. Where other house of worship, they may have all these different images, because they say they need a medium to communicate with God. Where we Muslims have been reminded by Allah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. When we want to worship Allah, we said, we worship you, O Allah, only you alone. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. Only you alone, we worship Allah. And Allahu Akbar. Even we are worshiping Allah alone, but still we use the term, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. Only you alone, we all worship. Just to remind us that this religion is for all of us. Islam is for all, not only for me and you. Even you are the one who's worshiping. I'm the one who's worshiping Allah, but I cannot change the word, إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدُ. I cannot say that. If I do that, my prayer is not valid. But if you look at the verses of Allah, why can't I change it? Because I'm the one who worship Allah. I should say, إِيَّاكَ أَعْبُدُ. No, you can't do that. You can't change the word of Allah. That means Allah wants you to remember that when you worship Allah, you should remember that every one of you, or you should call other people to worship the same God that you are worshiping. You must remind them. Don't just claim that Allah is one. Don't only say that you believe in one God, but you do not worship that one God that you claim. And that's why we must always remind ourselves, after we worship Allah, we also must invite other people, our children, our family, our friends, people who are not yet Muslim. Let us come together and let us, all of us, worship the only one God, the only true God, that is Allah. There's none worthy to be worshipped except Him alone. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Say, Allah is one, and He is the only one who have the right to be worshipped. Now, after doing that, then we know, Alhamdulillah, we do not just claim Allah is one, but we are proving to ourselves and also to Allah that we worship Him alone. When you have that kind of understanding from Tawhid Rububiyyah, you move to Tawhid Uluhiyyah, that shows that all of us now understand what is Islam. And we know that Islam is for all. And this is one thing that I like to remind myself and all my brothers and sisters and the audience. Please remember that Allah is not only our God, but is our, for all of you, not only for the Muslim, not only for me, but for all of you. He is my God and your gods. If you do not know him, I welcome you to Islam, because Islam is for all of us. And when you believe in the first article of faith, that is called Iman to Billah. Or the other term, they say Aman to Billah. You say, I believe in Allah. Alhamdulillah, we are clear about that. Then you come to the second article of faith, that is to believe in the angels of Allah. Now, every one of us believe there's angel. Only how you believe the angel may differ, but we all believe there's angel. Even the Chinese, even the people who are not a Muslim, when you talk to them about angels, they do believe there is a good spirit. Normally, when angel, they say good spirits. Nobody denies that there is good spirits. Even we can see them, maybe they don't have their name, like how the Muslim is being taught by Allah and the Prophet. Not only we believe in there is angel, but also we know some of the names of the angel, like Angel Gabriel, Mikael, Israfil, Munkar, Nakir, Redwan, Malik. We know some of them, not all of them, because there are many angels, to the extent that the Prophet ﷺ did remind us that. Now, every day, without fear, there are 70,000 of angels who enter Baitul Ma'mur and to make tawaf, because there is a place for them to make tawaf. And they will never come up. Every day, 70,000 of them enter Baitul Ma'mur and make tawaf, and they will not come up. There's many. There's a lot of angels. But at least there are some angels that Allah have mentioned their name in the Quran and in the Sunnah. At least now we Muslim, now we know some angels. Not only we say that we believe in angels, we also know their names and also their duties. It's very important. If you do not know them, and if you know them, you don't even know their duties, then you don't feel that you are close to them. Where these angels are very close to us, brothers and sisters. You can see them, but they see you. They can transform, yeah, in the form of a man and come to you. But because we do not know, and it's not easy for us to know, but inshallah, when you have the right understanding, then you will feel that the angel is so close to you, that wherever you are not alone. You're never alone. You always have some company, whether the good or the bad company. And then later on, we come to believe in the holy books. So may Allah bless us, and we hope that you will try your best to follow our program closely, so that Allah will enlighten us together and make us understand that Islam is for all. وَبِاللَّهِ تَوْفِيقِ وَالْأَقْرِ دَعْوَانَا وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ